Hey guys, so in this video I want to talk about PlayStation 4. It just came out, it was released yesterday, so it's a pretty big deal. It's a new console that's just come out, and I guess is this the beginning of next gen, which has now become current gen? I don't know, that's probably a debate for another time that will never happen with me, because it's not an important debate for me. Did next gen start with Wii U, or did next gen start with PS4, or should PS4 and Xbox One not even be considered next gen because they're so far behind current technology of what PC gaming or PCs can do in terms of gaming? Whatever. It's a pretty irrelevant discussion to me. All I know is that PS4 is out and I'm not going to buy it. And I'm personally not that interested in buying it for myself. But here's what I do think about, you know, PS4 overall. I think the launch is pretty cool. It's a pretty cool device. Pretty cool looking device. In terms of the size, you know, I don't really care much about the design, and I don't think design is that much of a factor in like whether you'll buy the console or not anyway. You know, a gaming console, I think most of all, as long as it's not like super 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 ugly and it's just such an eyesore, I don't think it matters like how it looks like. I personally think it's a pretty sleek design, but it's boring, you know. But I like the size, because the PS3, this fat motherfucker, like, shit. The original PS3 I have is such a pain in the ass to carry anywhere. It always has been, you know. It's this humongous, gigantic beast. Thank God it doesn't have a power brick cable. It's just, my parents, you know, they used to live in tents. California, I was in New York, carrying that to airport, anywhere. Now they live in Tennessee. Has always been such a pain, and trying to find a bag that fits into it because of its weird shape. So PS4, I'm really glad how it looks in terms of size, and it looks like it's not even that heavy. So that's pretty awesome. And still no brick cables, which is great. I hate power brick cables. And I still like the fact that, you know, PS4 controllers, just like DualShock 3 or whatever, no batteries needed. I've always hated that about like Xbox controllers, that you have to put like AAA or AA batteries. I hate the fact about Wii controllers. Like, I had to deal with that when I bought a Wii, and I'm just like, so this is what I've been missing out on for the past 5 years or something, and I'm glad. Because, you know, plugging my controller into the system and having it recharge, pretty much awesome for me. I like that. But anyway, PS4 launch. Doesn't look too shabby. It looks like a nice console, and some of the little nicer features that really like I want that, like that makes me go like that, is like being able to turn on your console and starting right from where you left off on the game or movie you're watching. To me, that's a pretty cool thing, because it's a little annoyance, but booting up the PS3, waiting for the whole thing to come up, and then putting in a game or starting up a game and waiting for the title logo screens and whatever, and then hitting load game and then getting to your save, and then when you have to quit the game, hitting the save and whatever, like that whole hassle is gone with PS4. I think that really appeals to me. I think that's pretty cool. It's cool to be able to download and play the game pretty much at the same time, although you're gonna have to wait a little bit, but that's pretty cool, because I just had to download the XCOM expansion. That's 7 gigabytes, and you know, PS3 download has always been the slowest when it comes to download speeds in comparison to other consoles, but such took so long. It's like, if I had to wait an hour, if there was an opportunity for me to just wait an hour and start playing it right away, shit, that's awesome. And that's what PS4 does, along with, you know, that's the same thing what Xbox One does. Pretty cool. And the launch lineup, not too shabby. I know a lot of people, I've been reading around, a lot of people are like, this is all, nothing interests me about the PS4 with the game launch lineup, you know. And it may not, but I know what launch lineup usually looks like. Compared to this, you know, compared the launch lineup to how it was for PS2, how it was for Xbox or Xbox 360 or PS3 or the Wii, and or the Wii U even. Not too bad, actually. The launch lineup for PS4, and Xbox One, not too shabby. It looks pretty good compared to that. And I would love to be able to play, you know, Assassin's Creed 4, Battlefield 4, Contrast, Retrogun. Knack, I'm not, you know, whatever, the graphics on that look really awesome, but not really sold on Knack. But Killzone Shadowfall looks amazing. So there are all these games that are on there day one for PS4, and I think that's pretty cool, and also for Xbox One, of course. But if I bought a next-gen console, you know it would be PS4. I've always been more of a PlayStation fan anyway. And there's a lot of things about Xbox One that bother me, but I'm not going to talk about that. So, pretty cool launch overall. Why am I not getting it? Or why did I not save? You know, I could buy it. I have money to do so. If my priority was not screwed up. If my priority was screwed up, I would go buy one right away. But it's not screwed up. It's pretty set straight in terms of money management. So, it really goes back to me going to FedEx 2 months ago. I had in my bag my PS3, which is a pain in the ass to carry around anywhere. Went to FedEx, and you know, I'm shipping this broken PS3 to a repair shop in Florida to get it repaired. I paid a little over $100 to have this repaired. So I chose to have this PS3 repaired. And so the guy, the FedEx employee, was like, you know the PS4 is coming out next month, right? And my reply was like, yeah, I know, but it doesn't play PS3. The PS4 is not going to be able to play PS3 games. That's the reason for me. If the PS4 plays PS3 games, I would have left this thing broken. I would not have fixed it. I would not have left the PS3 repaired. I would have gone, all right, time to move to the next generation of consoles. I'll wait a little bit, save this $100, and pull it in, buy a PS4. Boom, Sony would have got my money for the PS4 and its PS4 games. Especially because, you know, I really do like some of the downloadable titles that are on offer for PS4. But since that's not the case, and not only just PS3 games, but I don't understand why PlayStation Network games are not backwards compatible. I have so many PlayStation Network games. I would love to be just, you know, I don't know, there are so many I have. And not being able to transfer that is just ridiculous. It's just the fact that they're re-releasing Flower as an HD version for PS4, that's a weird thing. Flower for PS3 is already a gorgeous game. It's an awesome game, by the way. And beautifying it up a little bit for PS4, sure, it looks better, but I don't see the point. Why not be able to just play Flower that I bought on my PS4, instead of having to rebuy the game, to rebuy the re-release of the game that's enhanced a little bit. And also the cross-generation thing is bothersome. All right, we have Assassin's Creed 4, which you can play on both PS3 and PS4, but if you buy the PS3 version, you can't plug that in and you can't put that into a PS4 and play it. No, you have to pay $10 more to get the PS4 version and trade your PS3 version of the disc for the PS4 version of the game. What nonsense is this? Like, what? So, the cross-generation, I think, is an interesting idea. It also kind of shows that the gap between PS3 and PS4, the gap between Xbox 360 and Xbox One, not that huge. A lot of it is really on the memory side of things. You know, there's 8 gigabytes of RAM, whereas the previous generation, you know, they had to wrestle with 512 megabytes, 8 gigabytes of RAM. You know, this is a big deal in terms of like how many AI can be on the screen and the processing power. Visually, I don't think it's gonna make that big of a difference. But we see now reports of some companies struggling to make that 60 frames per second, 1080p. And I personally think that's going to be an issue throughout the generation because this is pretty dated tech compared to what PCs can do now. But that aside, the gap in terms of visual fidelity, I don't guess it's going to be that big of a deal. And that's not the thing that would sell me on the PS4 anyway. Games already look pretty damn good on the PS3. On the PS4, it's gonna look knack. I was looking at the gameplay footage of that, like beautiful, gorgeous visuals. You know, Killzone Shadowfall, amazing looking. If that's as far as graphics can go, sure, whatever. I can accept that. But the fact that there is now this humongous split, you know, I'm not gonna be buying PS4. I'm just gonna enjoy my PS3 for years longer. And then maybe down the road, maybe PS4. But by that point, I think I'll just take the smarter route and invest my money into buying a decent PC for about $600 and go PC gaming, you know? But PS4, just because of this backwards compatibility issue, has really lost me as a customer.